choosing a right career is very important for our personal and professional happiness, and thankfully most of the people are aware of it. A recent survey shows, and this was done with some of the most reputed organizations, and the data reveals that 85% of the people are unhappy. This is shocking. You know, on one hand we say follow your passion, and it's not that they don't know. On the other hand, so many people are unhappy, so where is the problem? It was revealed that there are three specific reasons why people are unhappy, even though they know the follow your passion philosophy. This video can be a game changer in your life, primarily because you will be able to discover what are those three reasons, and also how do you discover your passion. Do make sure that you watch this video till the end, because there is a massive twist in the tale and an insight that very few people in the world are aware, and that could be a game changer in your life. Hi, my name is V. Neeraj Kumar. Thank you so much for watching this channel. If you believe this video has added some value to your life, kindly consider liking it. It will be a huge motivation for me and my team, and it would be an honor to have you as my subscriber. You know, I have made an effort, and I continue to make a lot of efforts to bring some of the best insights across the world. And most of my videos are a little longer, primarily because I know the kind of people this video will help. And unless you've been very serious about your life, you wouldn't have clicked my channel. I'm committed, and if there is any value that you find, the credit goes to all those people I have learned from. And if there is any mistake, the credit goes to me. You know, a lot of things have changed in the last 50 years in the field of career and follow your passion. 50 years ago, there was nothing called follow your passion. My mom got married to my dad because my dad has a government job. And back then, if you had to get married, you had to have two jobs. One is a government job, otherwise a bank job. Otherwise, it would have been impossible for you to get a girl. Things have been slightly better. And when I was doing my final engineering 1991, around that time, there was nothing called a campus interview, and getting a job was a huge thing. So follow your passion, do what you like, unheard of. All we had was somehow get a job, get a secure job, and become somebody in life. But in 2000, probably late 1990s and early 2000s, a lot of things have changed. You know, this revolution began when Mr. Steve Jobs gave a lecture in Stanford University in 2005. And that lecture actually created ripples across the world. And the lecture was, do what you like, find your passion, and don't settle till then. These were his exact words. And the entire world went berserk, because back then Steve Jobs was known to be the mover and shaker, the trendsetter. This revolution actually took a massive turn in India, I think around 2010. I'll tell you why. There was a movie that was released called Three Idiots. And this movie was all about, don't be a part of the rat race, don't go after marks or academic success alone, do what you like, follow your passion. And the message was beautiful, and it was extremely well received by the Indians. More than that, this actually movie was remade in several South Indian languages, and it was a super hit. And there was a paradigm shift in the thinking of the society. Many of the people have changed, obviously not everyone. And those parents, all of a sudden, who were earlier believing in a traditional career like, okay, become an engineer or a doctor, they changed slightly. All of a sudden, Indian parents became very progressive. You know, there was a movie called Dilwale Dulhaniya Le Jayenge. In that movie, last scene, when Amrish Puri lets his daughter to go and live with Shah Rukh Khan, and he says, Ja Simran Ja, Zile Apni Jindagi. Metaphorically, that's what parents have gone through now in the last 15 years or so, where they say they are allowing their kids to live their passion. And that's when the actual problem started. So I mentioned to you three specific problems. Problem number one, do you know over 90% of the people don't know what they're passionate about? It is not that they don't want to follow their passion. The bigger problem is they don't know what they're passionate about. I will tell you my experience. I work with a lot of corporations and education institutions, where I do a program called Campus to Corporate, where we get the fresh hires to be ready for the corporate world. And during my conversation in the breaks, I keep asking a lot of graduate students, so what are you passionate about? What do you want to become? And a typical answer I get is, I want to become a vice president of this company. I said, wow. Then I asked him, why not senior vice president? He's kind of a perplexed and he says, you know what, Neeraj, I don't know all these titles, but I want to make a lot of money. And he says, I don't know what am I passionate about. I want to become somebody in life. Look at this. So it is not that he is passionate about becoming a vice president. In his own words, he wants a lot of money. And it is not only with him, it is true with corporate professionals. You know, they join a job because it's a high paying job, and after some time, because they don't like their job, they feel very stuck and they don't know what to do, but they don't like what they're doing. Look at the problem. And this is not only with the corporate professionals, it is also getting extended to homemakers, very talented homemakers who have had some stint in the corporate life and they get married, and as we know, they sacrifice their career on a family way, and after some time they want to get back. Somehow they don't like to go back to what they were doing and they don't know what to do. They are qualified, feel stuck. So students have a problem, they don't know what to do, 90%. Corporate professionals, they don't like their job, they want to do something, they don't know what they're passionate about. Homemakers are in the similar boat. So all these things are actually adding up to one message. People don't know what they're truly passionate about. You have to understand this. They're what they're truly passionate about. This is a very important word. Challenge number two is, they think making money is passion. That is not true. That's what exactly students keep telling me. The money is a resultant of passion and it is never a cause. The bigger challenge is challenge number three. You know what? Because they don't know what they truly are passionate about, they think successful people's career is their passion. So they become what we call dabblers. They keep trying different things. So let me open a restaurant. And they get into that, they burn their fingers because they don't know the trick of the trade and they get bored very shortly. And somebody says, okay, let me get into web designing. Then they get into photography. Then they get into travel vlogging. So what people are typically doing, because they are not 100% sure of what they're passionate about, they keep trying because they are not happy with what they're doing. This is actually a much bigger problem, because the reason why they do is because some wise uncle would have advised them that, okay, do this, it's good for you. Do this, there is a scope. Do this, there is a lot of money. But what are you passionate about? And because they don't know how to discover that, they yield into the pressure of the society or so-called the wise people. Let me tell you another huge problem. This is actually not a part of the three problems. This is kind of a generic. There is a huge confusion between skill and passion today. Just because you are good at something does not mean you like it. So we must move away from a culture saying you are good at numbers, so become a finance guy, you are good at dancing, become a dancer, to what do you really like? And let me tell you, this is so serious that because we have a lot of people who are exceptional at solving problems, they become IT professionals. I'm just giving a very specific example. And they're so good at coding, but after some time I work with them one-on-one and they tell me, you know what, Neeraj, I'm very good at what I do, but I simply hate doing it. Think about it. But if there is a marriage between what are you good at and what you like, that's a lethal combination, and we are not talking about that. It is only a confusion that we want to address, that just because you are good does not mean it has to become your career. Okay, now that you understand a complete picture of the challenges we have with discovering the passion, is it worth following a passion? 100%, don't even have a doubt. It is just that we have to be smart in discovering our passion, and that's exactly what we will do now. Let us take a very scientific and a proven approach to discovering your passion, friends. The reason I'm spending a little time here, because this is your life and we are on a very serious discussion. Step number one, to follow your passion, you must be good at what you are passionate about. Let me repeat. If you are passionate about music, you must be good at music. That means you must be born with musical intelligence. If you are passionate about cricket or any other sports, you must be born with kinesthetic or bodily intelligence. If you are passionate about politics, you must be extremely extremely good at linguistic and interpersonal intelligence. So you must have that intelligence in you, then only that can become a passion. Otherwise it can at most become a hobby. So this is the confusion between what is a hobby and what is a passion. Passion is something that you like and you are good at it. What do I mean by you must be born with that intelligence? Yes, every single human being is born with multiple intelligences. There are 8 intelligences every human being is born with. So you must be wondering, where do I get this information? I understand there is a video specifically on this topic in my channel. Kindly subscribe, and the title of the video is Secret Intelligence of Rich and Famous. You will get a complete understanding of all the 8 intelligences, and also how do you discover your top 3 dominant intelligences. So now that you understand the step number 1, that you have to be good at something before making it into a passion, after that, how do you discover your passions? Step number 2, you have to identify the activity that you are doing or something that you are passionate about with respect to 5 criteria that I will be talking to you. So criteria number 1, any activity that you do must bring a sustained feeling of happiness and achievement, and you would be wanting to do more of it. I repeat, a sustained feeling of happiness and achievement. This is very critical, because there is always this enthusiasm burst that we have. I like this, you know, after some time, no, it's getting bored, so I'll go to the second one. No, that's not a sustained feeling. The sustained feeling has to be over a period of months to years. For example, in my case, I had a very sustained feeling of happiness and achievement when I started coaching people, when I started training people, and this began probably 30 years ago. I used to love teaching when I was in my college or when I was in my first job. I just loved it. So this is a sustained feeling that has continued for over 3 decades now. That's the first criteria. The second criteria, any activity that you are planning to do or make it a passion should feel good before doing it, while doing it, and after doing it. So that means the moment you think of it, you must feel fantastic that you're going to do that. While doing, you should enjoy that. And after doing, you must have that sense of satisfaction. Wow, what a time well spent. This is very critical. And please understand, it has to be legal and agreeable to your conscience. You cannot say, you know, I feel fantastic before doing drugs and while and after. No, that's not allowed. So do the drag racing. So these are not the ones, and your conscience is the best judge and the jury for this. Criteria number 3, any activity that keeps you awake the entire night and you don't want to sleep, or pulls you out of the bed in the morning, and while doing it, you are in the zone, you don't know how the time goes by. This is an exact criteria to know that you are passionate about it. In fact, our beloved former president, Dr. Abdul Kalam, he was in a meeting with his team. Meeting started quite late in the evening. He had told the tea boy to come next day morning for the tea and not to be disturbed before that. And after a short time, he hears the knock on the door and he sees the tea boy standing with the tea, and he says, I told you to come tomorrow. Why are you here? He said, sir, it's already tomorrow and it's already 7 in the morning. So that is how passionate they were. This is called being in the zone. So activity that you do, are you in the zone? Criteria number 4, any activity you are never bored of talking. You just want to talk about it. You want to explore more of it. Even if you are in a party and somewhere in the corner, somebody is talking about it, you just leave everything and go join that conversation. And you can't stop talking about it. You're so passionate about it. Criteria number 5, any activity you don't mind doing it free. And if you're too passionate, and this is an actual acid test, let me tell you, you don't mind paying and doing it. That is passion. So these are the 5 criteria that you must check with something that you may call, am I passionate about this? So this will give you an idea. You know, this will actually bring a bigger challenge now. So if you're able to tick all the 5 criteria, I promise you, you have found your passion. But what if you are not able to tick all the 5 boxes? You're able to probably tick 1 or 2. In that case, how do you find your passion? That's exactly what we will learn now. And this is called a roadmap towards passion. We call this the first step towards discovering your passion is to discover your interest. know, everyone has an area of interest. If you could recall, either yourself or people around you, they were either interested in sports or probably in drama and acting or probably in science and experiments. So you will see this interest broadly getting developed from our childhood, and they are distinctly different. So that is your first step towards identifying your passion. But you may say, but Neeraj, that's kind of a subjective, it is changing because we are kind of being subjected to the societal brainwashing thing, doesn't make money. That's exactly what we will learn. We call this a very process-driven approach to identifying your interest. So to identify your passion, you need to know what are your primary interests. So how do you discover your interest? I recommend two websites. One, personalitymatch.com. It is a free website. You get a report, but not a very comprehensive one, but you will get a broad understanding of your interest areas and also your top three dominant intelligences. The second one is a very wonderful one. It is called Strong Interest Inventory. This is from a company called Myers-Briggs from the US. It's almost 80 years old, and this assessment was developed by a professor called E.K. Strong. This person, unlike a psychometric test or a skill or aptitude test, did something very different. He identified people who are extremely happy in their career. And this is from almost 30 different occupational themes and over 250 jobs, and identified their interests and formed a kind of a profile. In this strong interest inventory, you are given an assessment. You need to answer about 292 questions. And what is very, very nice about this is your answers are compared with those who are extremely happy in their career. And that is how the relative score is developed. And it gives you exactly which is your area of interest. Isn't this wonderful? It also recommends 10 different occupations that could suit your interest areas and your working style. So, how would this help? I have found this instrument extremely useful myself. I have learned it, I have used it for myself, found it very, very valuable when I did this. It gave me top 10 professions which are probably which I did and what I'm doing now. I can vouch for this efficacy because when I administered this with my wife, she was able to identify her passion as counseling. She was a veena player, she was an interior designer, she was a web designer. But when this assessment happened, she was taken by a surprise when she found out that counseling is her area of interest and that could become a potential passion. And when she spent some time, she had that sustained feeling of happiness and achievement. And she did her qualifications, several certifications across the globe. And she's a full-time counselor now, running her practice very well. You may visit her website, varadawellness.com. You would know there are so many therapies that can help you do better in your life. It has not only yielded good results for me, my wife, and some of my friends and relatives. I have had this confidence to recommend this for some of my clients and a lot of people. They have found it extremely invaluable, and it has actually helped those parents who were completely confused about their kids' future, and the adolescents were curious, rather confused about their own passion because their passions kept on changing almost on a monthly basis. So this kind of gave them a very good direction on which direction they should head to. And it's been 5-6 years now. I've seen some amazing results across whomever I have tried with. In India, there is a representative called Anahat.in. So they are the official distributors for this instrument, and you may visit their website. You will get further details on that. Now that you are clear about how do you discover your passion and a roadmap to discover your passion, time for the twist that I promised you in the beginning of the video. You know, what is the twist? Following your passion can be dangerous. What am I saying? You know, all this while I said discover your passion, you will be super happy and thrilled in life. And now I'm saying following your passion is dangerous. Absolutely. And trust me, when I heard this for the first time, I was shocked. But let me tell you, this question or this concept answered a lot of questions in my mind. And one of the questions that has been answered is, why do celebrities commit suicide? Why do rich and famous people commit suicide? And why are they so unhappy in their life? It is not that they have not followed their passion. In fact, they have followed their passion. They have been super successful. But in spite of that, why did they end their life or why are they unhappy? I'm not saying all of them, but some of them. So when I found this missing piece of the puzzle, I got an answer. It is not mere following your passion can be dangerous. There is something more to it. What is it? It is called, do you know what is your purpose? 99% of the people in the world are not aware of the difference between passion and purpose. It's shocking, but it is true. You may be aware of your passion, but if you are not aware of your purpose, then the whole thing falls apart and your life seems pretty hollow. In the next video, I will answer three questions. Question number one, what is the guarantee that the claim that I have made, passion can be dangerous, how valid it is? Second question, what is the difference between passion and purpose and how do I find my purpose? Third question that I will be answering is, how do we put all these three things together and come up with a foolproof plan to identify a passion, identify the purpose, and come up with a fantastic career plan that will not only make you happy, but also extremely fulfilled and lead a very purposeful life. I hope I was able to add some value to your life with the insights that I have gathered. If you believe it is worth it, again, my humble request, give us a like. And press that bell icon, because the moment I release some amazing videos, you will instantly be notified and you can watch it at your convenience. And again, it will be an honor to have you as my subscriber. Thank you very much for watching this video. Take care. Till then, keep learning, keep sharing.